CFA as well. We're looking to and have worked with and are continuing to work with Fair Share Scotland to ensure that that is a one-way to distribute food and
till you tell me how I may rescue you, swore the knight, still kneeling. Alas, my cruel fate condemns me to remain here till my tyrant is destroyed. Where is the villain? In the Mauve Salon. Go, brave heart, and save me from despair. I obey and return victorious or dead. With these thrilling words, he rushed away, and flinging open the door of the Mauve Salon, was about to enter when he received a stunning blow from the big Greek lexicon, which an old fellow in a black gown fired at him, said Ned. Instantly, Sir What's-His-Name recovered himself, pitched the tyrant out of the window, and turned to join the lady, victorious but with a bump on his brow. Found the door locked, tore up the curtains, made a rope ladder. Got halfway down when the ladder broke, and he went headfirst into the moat, 60 feet below. Could swim like a duck, paddled round the castle, till he came to a little door, guarded by two stout fellows. Knocked their heads together, till they cracked like a couple of nuts. Then, by a trifling exertion of his prodigious strength, he smashed in the door, went up a pair of stone steps, covered with dust a foot thick, toads as big as your fist, and spiders that would frighten you into hysterics, Miss March. At the top of these steps, he came plump upon a sight that took his breath away and chilled his blood. A tall figure, all in white, with a veil over its face and a lamp in its wasted hand, went on Meg. It beckoned, gliding noiselessly before him down a corridor as dark and cold as any tomb. Shadowy effigies in armor stood on either side. A dead silence reigned. The lamp burned blue, and the ghostly figure ever and anon turned its face toward him, showing the glitter of awful eyes through its white veil. They reached a curtained door, behind which lovely music sounded. He sprang forward to enter, but the spectre plucked him back and waved threateningly before him a snuffbox, said Joe in a sepulchral tone which convulsed the audience. Thank ye, said the knight politely as he took a pinch and sneezed 7 times so violently that his head fell off. Aha, laughed the ghost, and having peeped through the keyhole of the princess's spinning away for dear life, the evil spirit picked up her victim and put him in a large tin box, where there were 11 other knights packed together without their heads like sardines, who all rose and began to dance a hornpipe, cut in Fred as Joe paused for breath. And as they danced, the rubbishy old castle turned to a man of war in full sail. Up with the jib! Reef the topsail halyards, helm hard alee and man the guns, roared the captain as a Portuguese pirate hove in sight with a flag black as ink flying from her foremast. Go in and win, my hearties, says the captain, and a tremendous fight began. Of course the British beat, they always do. No, they don't, cried Joe aside. Having taken the pirate captain prisoner, sailed slap over the schooner, whose decks were piled with dead, and whose lee scuppers ran blood, for the order had been cutlasses and die hard. Bosun's mate, take a bite of the flying jib sheet, and start this villain if he don't confess his sins double quick, said the British captain. The Portuguese held his tongue like a brick, and walked the plank while the jolly tars cheered like mad. But the sly dog dived, came up under the man of war, scuttled her, and down she went with all sails set to the bottom of the sea, see, where... Oh, gracious, what shall I say? Cried Sally, as Fred ended his rigmarole, in which he had jumbled together pell-mell nautical phrases and facts out of one of his favorite books. Well, they went to the bottom, and a nice mermaid welcomed much grieved on finding the box of headless knights, and kindly pickled them in brine, hoping to discover the mystery about them, for being a woman, she was curious. By and by, a diver came down, and the mermaid said, I'll give you this box of pearls if you can take it up. For she wanted to restore the poor things to life, and couldn't raise the heavy load herself. So the diver hoisted it up, and was much disappointed on opening it to find no pearls. He left it in a great lonely field, where it was found by a little goose girl, who kept 100 fat geese in the field, said Amy, when Sally's invention gave out. The little girl was sorry for them, and asked an old woman what she could do to help them. Your geese will tell you they know everything, said the old woman. So she asked what she should use.